Hey guys, I am Game Advisor and welcome back to another Tarkov video. Today we're going to be talking about our top 10 Tarkov tips for beginning and new players. Now, there is a lot more out there which we will cover hopefully in some future videos, but let us know down below if that's something you want to see or if there's any tips that are super important that you think we missed out on. That being said, let's get started with number 1. First up on our list is probably one of the easiest ones to do, which is to look up Tarkov maps. You can do this on your phone if you don't have a second monitor, but it's really nice to have them present as it helps you to navigate where you're going, figure out where extractions are, where loot is. It's just an incredibly powerful tool for you to have, even though it does require you to use some third-party software, either via somebody's website or through an in-game overlay via Overwolf. Second is that you should be examining everything when you first start out from the traders in order to get A, some free XP, and B, just so you know what they are. All you need to do is go ahead and go to the traders window, go ahead and right click on items and then hit examine, and then you're going to go ahead and get a bunch of free XP simply for doing this. Fence does also have new items come in fairly often, so make sure you're checking him as he will have new ones that you haven't seen before, especially when you're starting out because once again, it's free XP, but aside from that, it's just another thing you won't have to examine in the middle of a raid. Third is kind of a bonus tip for number 2, and that's just the simple fact that you can examine things by hitting middle mouse button. Of course, you can re-keybind this if that's something you want to do, but this seems to work perfect for me. All you need to do is just push your middle mouse button into your mouse, and it will start to examine things by simply mousing over them, rather than having to right-click and open up that drop-down window. This may seem silly and like it's not that big of a deal, but when you're in the middle of a raid, it can make a huge difference. Our fourth tip on the list today is that you should be practicing a few games in bot lobbies so that you don't lose any loot. This is incredibly important when you're first starting out because Tarkov does not explain anything to you. It is pretty much eat or be eaten when it comes to this game, so I highly, highly recommend you go into a bot lobby as soon as possible, take your best gear you can or whatever guns you want to play around with, go ahead and try shooting some scavs, try figuring out where loot's at, get the good layout of some of the maps. I would recommend customs as being the first one you should probably learn because there's going to be a lot of starter quests there, but anyways, the goal here is just to get yourself acquainted with the game or acquainted with a new map maybe you haven't played yet. You're going to want to go ahead and play in those bot lobbies. Halfway there with number 5 is the fact that if you kill a scav as a scav, you will lower your rep with fence and make his trades therefore more expensive, as well as his vehicle extracts, and cause other scavs to start attacking you for the remainder of that run. Every scav you kill in that run from there on out will also continue to lower your reputation, so I highly recommend you do your absolute best not to, as it's gonna hurt you in the long run. Sixth is just the simple fact that you should always bring meds, and we're talking about bringing a bandage, a tourniquet, some painkillers, a cheese or some other form of healing, and if you can, a suture kit or something like a survival kit that will allow you to be able to go ahead and fix those blacked out limbs. None of these are necessarily mandatory except for the bandages, because if you bleed out, you're essentially dead, but at the end of the day, it is very much so worth it. I cannot tell you how many times my life has been saved simply by bringing a couple cheeses and a couple bandages in my alpha container. Seventh is one of the relatively new mechanics, which is just the simple fact that tourniquets are used as heavy bandages. So if you ever have heavy bleeding and you see that when you're looking at your health screen, you're going to want to go ahead and pull out the little red cinnamon roll looking thing, which is a tourniquet. Go ahead and use that on it instead of a regular bandage. I personally didn't realize this at first when I came back to the game, but it's a very important mechanic, and if you don't take it seriously, you will bleed out very, very fast and there is nothing you can do about it. Eighth is that by clicking and holding ammo in your inventory, you will see what it could be used with. If it is available to be used with something, it'll turn green, otherwise it'll probably turn yellow, indicating it doesn't either currently have enough room for that ammo or it currently has an attachment, because this does work for attachments as well in that slot. So it's just something to be aware of, as the devs have basically just made the game a lot easier for you to understand what ammo goes with what guns and what attachments go with what guns. Ninth is that Control-T will check the ammo in your current magazine without having to move the mag out of your gun. If you didn't already know this one, this is actually an extremely, extremely useful tip if you're just starting out. You'll notice sometimes when you look at your gun in your inventory, you'll see a little question mark indicating that you don't know how much ammo is in it. Well, you could count the rounds as you fire them, or you could just go ahead and hit Control-T while it's in your hands without opening your inventory, and it will then go ahead and tell you roughly how much ammo is in it. If you want to know the exact amount of ammo, you're going to have to take the mag out and examine that in order to figure out how much ammo is in the mag exactly. Coming in at number 10 is our final tip today, which is that anything you put in your alpha container or beta or gamma container, whichever one you happen to have, will be taken out with you even if you die. However, it will not be counted as found in raid, which a lot of quests require items to be. This means if you find something worth a lot of money or really valuable, or maybe it's just some part of a quest that you need that doesn't require the item to be found in raid, you're going to want to go ahead and shove that in your alpha container. You'll actually hear of something called a hatchling, which is when a new player or a player who just doesn't want to risk anything goes in with absolutely no loot to a map, grabs as many things as they can and shoves them in their alpha container or quest items if that's what they're doing, as well as anything they can fit in their pockets, and then runs to the exit. This is a way to get some money if you're really that broke and don't have a scav to play, but it's generally frowned upon, so I personally don't recommend it. But hey, it's Tarkov, you do you. With all that being said, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more survival game and Tarkov content. If you thought there were any tips once again that we didn't mention and you think new players absolutely need to know, or something maybe you just didn't know that you wish you knew when you started Tarkov, please feel free to comment them down below to help out other players. And with that, I'm Game Advisor. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.
No! No! Are you f***ing kidding me? No!